Cleopatra, after the civil war that followed the assassination of Caesar, met with Mark Antony in Assyria, where they planned the defense of Egypt against the Romans. Before leaving, Cleopatra entrusted her young daughter Sheila to the rulers of Assyria to be brought up as their own. After Mark Antony's defeat and Cleopatra's death, Egypt for the next 20 years was torn apart and ruled by a youthful pharaoh, Nemerat, with his despot queen mother, Teghi, who desired to unite both kingdoms and strengthen her son's rule by conquering Assyria and making Sheila, now a beautiful woman, his queen.
Physician?
Not yet. Why? Has the sky fallen?
Here I am. What are you so excited about?
I thought I was waiting.
I know. I'm on my way now. Tabor, hurry up.
What illness I invented today?
Who knows?
Move on there. Move on. Hurry!
Let's get on your feet. Move on there. Hey, you get back here.
On your feet. On your feet.
A whip like yours is meant for dummies.
You want a taste of it, too?
You want to kill her? They're enemies of our pharaoh.
Give me the
water. I forbid you to interfere.
You're not to judge, let alone condemn her.
Sekhmet.
Take the girl and follow me.
Why? What do you want of her?
Layla,
who are you taking her?
My child.
Let her alone.
Stay
with
your hands off her.
Can I hold
her? Let's get along here.
My child.
Get
out
of here. Let's go.
Bring her along.
Get me out of your king.
My child. No.
A merchant sometimes returns with something priceless which was unknown before. In those far-off countries, there are many wise men. Here you can always call Ito. You have as much confidence in him as in me.
You know what they're saying? That during these travels of yours, you even go to kill the poor.
The physician cures illness wherever he finds it.
So only the poor have illnesses for you. And I don't. I wonder why I'm seized by these sudden chills and terrors. I heard of someone. One night an ant found its way into his ear without his knowing it. He went mad just before he died.
There are no ants in the palace.
And there are gnats and flies. And other insects here. A mosquito could have gotten into my ear. And then into my brain. I'm splitting headaches. My brain is on fire. And don't you tell me it's nothing.
Well, if this is really so, there is a way to cure your headaches. Remove the top of the skull, correct, Ito?
Huh?
Yes, remove the top of the skull and look for the mosquito. As an operation, it would be rather difficult. 1 in 100 is successful. But if you wish, I could perform it on a slave as an experiment, and then...
Can't you see that your physician is joking? Instead of inventing new ailments, my son, listen to me carefully. I must admit, she's far more beautiful even than I have been led to believe.
Whom do you mean?
I mean the daughter of Cleopatra, Sheila.
Didn't you have him all put to death?
She might be very useful to us. Assyria lies at our feet today. And throughout the Orient, everyone trembles with fear when they hear your name. But this is still not enough for a complete and lasting conquest. A day will come when a king who is your son must ascend this throne. And his mother will be a descendant of Cleopatra.
I'm listening to you, mother. The king will be my son.
What a thing to say. But I've no intention of ever getting married. You yourself, mother, put me on my guard against women. They're all evil. That's what you said, evil. And here you are all of a sudden.
Nothing is more unstable than the throne of a king who has no children. And I have chosen for you the most beautiful of women.
But she's our enemy.
She won't be from the moment you embrace her.
She'll always hate us for having killed her people.
For the crown of the two kingdoms, any woman would be willing to kill her father and mother with her own bare hands. Ordinarily, her own life is the one for which she really cares. I promise you.
My health is too delicate.
What is your opinion, physician?
I think our sovereign's health would improve if he were to marry.
There, you see?
Is this another cure of yours?
It's a cure we've known of for ages.
Sit on your throne, my son. Now you shall see her. She's as gentle and timid as a young gazelle. I bid you welcome here. See, we do not receive you as an enemy. Come. Mm-hmm. You are here at the gracious command of the Lord of Upper and Lower Egypt, the divine son of Amun-Ra, the sole giver of life.
What could the Lord of Two Lands possibly want of me?
She is beautiful. She pleases me. But what will people say? What will the priests say when they behold the daughter of a traitor beside me on the throne of the pharaohs?
They will finally accept the fact that Egypt and Assyria are bound by ties of affection. Listen to me carefully, Sheila. We could easily enslave your whole nation by sending thousands of people to work and die in the limestone quarries. We would prefer instead to have your people and our people consider each other friends. But this depends entirely on you. Tomorrow you may be either adored or cursed by your people. It's for you to decide.
You can't mean that I have a choice. I'm a prisoner.
No, not anymore. You must forget everything that has happened to you up to now. Forget the past.
Forget it? Yes, maybe I could. If I knew that all my people would go free and that my father and my mother and all...
You must not think about them any longer. They too belong to the past for you now. They are of no further importance either to you or to your people.
No, it's not true. I don't believe it. Tell me it's not true.
It is too late. They turned against us and they've paid for it. No. A queen must always restrain her emotions.
No! You murderer! You filthy swine! You murderer! Let me go!
Control yourself.
Let me go! I thought you were different, just like all the rest. Why didn't you kill me too? Why? Please. Please let me see them just once. Take me to them.
No, you must forget them.
My mother. My father, brother. I can't object to my giving them goodbye. I'm like praying for them.
Take her away. Ailid, you are to look after her.
No. No, please. Please let me see her. Have mercy. Please get me this door. Please. Please go with your little Navajo. Please. No, don't light the lamp. Go away.
Sheila.
Who is it?
I am Raisi, the physician.
Only those who wish to live need a doctor. Go away, leave me alone.
I saw your relatives. I went to see them to be sure, to be able to tell you that at least they were not tortured. They died painlessly.
Painlessly? How would you know?
Believe me, it was over in less than a moment.
My younger brother was just a baby. How could anyone kill a child? Why would they kill me, too? I haven't anything left to live for.
When you're sure that you'd rather be dead than alive, it helps to take a breath. It helps to look up at the sun or at the river as it flows on forever. Anything that will make us want to go on living as long as we possibly can, because it's only right that we should. Why can't you accept the offer they've made you? Each one of us has been put on Earth for some reason.
It will be over in a moment. Without pain, that's what you said, isn't it? So why do you ask me to submit to the one man I hate more than anyone else in the world?
Perhaps he may deserve your compassion more than your hatred. Certainly your life wouldn't be easy with him, but you mustn't lose the chance. You know, maybe you could bring happiness to the tortured souls in this palace. Perhaps Nimarrat would be less cruel with you to guide him.
Is that your only reason? You have no other?
I want you to go on living. I want to be able to see you. I want...
Please, what is it, Reese? Please don't go. I'm not frightened when you're here.
You must learn to rely on your own courage. When I return, you will be the Queen of Egypt. Don't ever say no to life.
Show them no mercy. Let your wrath be as swift and deadly as the wrath of Horus the Falcon. For years, the valley where the kings are entombed has been infested with these jackals, who desecrate the tombs and plunder them. They tremble at your feet, but they are craftier than serpents. On account of them, I, Mana, superintendent of the necropolis, have come under suspicion. Why doesn't he bring them in, was the question. He has soldiers enough to protect the valley of the kings. And many hasten to whisper it in your ears. There is my reply.
That's not true, mighty Pharaoh.
I should have cut out their tongues. They bore me with their whining and complaining.
Listen to the prisoner.
Oh, queen, gracious queen, you are beautiful. You must also be merciful.
That was our first.
Our children were dying of starvation.
Tomb had been plundered before. There were only a few fragments left inside it.
Don't listen to these grave robbers. Punish them. And from now on, the valley will be fully respected, I assure you.
Can you foretell the future as well?
It will be respected because the robbers are there at your feet. Pay attention to your architecture and try to construct better tomb.
Oh, certainly. Since your guards are blind.
I will not permit you to insult my...
That's fine. It's entertaining. But on a boxing match, I'd like to see it.
Thank you, my king. But this is not the occasion.
Great King Nemerat, I am asking you for justice only, and especially for myself.
Justice is done.
Punish these thieves.
Mercy! Have mercy, Father!
Punish
these
thieves!
Don't punish
us!
We didn't say we had it at all! I should have been
sorry! Permit me to remind you that according to our laws, they have to be killed by being thrown to the crocodiles.
I shall decide after dinner. You coming, Sheila?
Where is he? It's you.
The gods have sent you here. Save us. You alone can do it. They're going to kill us.
What's happened? What have you done?
Nothing. We were searching in a tomb.
Are these the wise and brilliant men you consult in your lengthy travels? Is it their knowledge you wish to consult?
Save us!
Don't let them do this to us. We're not the robbers of the valley. Don't leave us. We did wrong, but we're not the grave robbers they're looking for. Oh, save us! Help us!
Have mercy! Help! Don't let them do it.
Is my sovereign in good health and suffering no ill?
I want you to answer my question. As physician to the pharaoh, you touch and give treatment to beggars.
For a physician, the various elements of anatomy are the same in all men. Studying them helps me to cure you.
Once you suggested removing the top of my skull. But if any skull is to be removed, it's your own. Be thankful you're a good physician and that I'm in need of you.
My friend, you should take the pharaoh's advice. Why not drill a hole in that thick skull of yours and get rid of the idiotic principles that are there?
Why did they arrest those poor devils?
According to Mana, they're a band of grave robbers who have been desecrating the tombs of the pharaohs in the Valley of the Kings.
But that's absurd. They wouldn't be so emaciated if they were robbing tombs.
Let's pardon a whole lot of them. Let's set them at liberty and imprison only fat men hereafter, according to Rezi. And the desecrators of the tombs will multiply. And tomorrow the sacred valley where the kings are resting will be the nightly haunt of every evildoer in the two kingdoms.
Something of the sort might easily occur. But I don't think it's right to call them evildoers.
Rezi, you disturb me. What new theory is this?
The people are hungry. Grain is not being distributed regularly. In many villages, they haven't had as much as a handful.
Who dares to say so?
I've seen it.
Ah, you have seen them not distributing the grain, then. A great revelation.
I have witnessed the famine. And you yourself saw it a moment ago.
And you believe wretches like that? You take their word against mine, Catherine's? The right hand of the pharaoh? The chief overseer of his household? I declare that the grain is regularly distributed throughout the land. And moreover, in abundance.
Catherine, don't exaggerate. All the granaries you possess are filled with enough for 1,000 villages.
This is defamation. Who told you this?
The swallow. Who would like to play with me?
With pleasure, my king.
No, you always beat me. Mana.
I am honored.
Inoni, you must convince me that my tomb will be safe with all these robberies going on.
You can rest assured of that. I have constructed a maze with many pitfalls in it, and I'm the only person alive who knows all its secrets. No one could ever get out alive, even if he did get inside.
I hope you're telling me the truth. Since my childhood, I've dreamt of this tomb. I want it to be a splendid one. I want everything. Everything I find amusing. This game board, for example, with all its pieces and the dice. And I'd better have Mana because I can beat him. What do you say we send him to the embalmers at once?
According to the customs of our ancient kings,
yes.
We could...
The ancient kings used to have even their queens buried in their tombs with them. Sheila, wouldn't you be willing to come with me? We could make the long voyage together. We'd be presented at the same time to the god Osiris who'd weigh our hearts. We'd live together forever on the beach above the sun. Together always, Sheila, and our happiness would never come to an end. Mana, you haven't lost the game yet. I feel half a pound already. What beautiful mummies all of us are going to be.
Master. Is the Pharaoh unwell?
No. On the contrary, the Pharaoh is feeling so well today that he's gone hunting. You've been gone a long time.
I visited many countries. I even went to the far-off land of Red Rocks where you were born.
And my people?
The Pharaoh has kept his promise. They are not enslaved. You came here to ask me this?
Yes. I've paid personally for them.
They know it, and they appreciate it. I heard your name spoken by the humblest of people, country folk and shepherds, and even the children. They all hope that you are happy here.
Happy? Your life is filled with happiness, Rissi. You're continually met with looks of hope and gratitude. You can give and receive. If only I could feel a little of your joy, Rissi.
If it were mine to give, you could have it.
The Pharaoh will be coming back shortly. I wish it were different. I wish that his men would come back and shout that the Pharaoh was dead, that he'd fallen from his chariot, or was killed by a lion, or some wild beast.
Sheila.
I loathe him.
You must not come here again.
You said you wanted me to live. Why? So many times, Nanai, awakened and said to myself, this is where you would spend the rest of your life, Sheila. Day by day, nothing changing. This is where I would grow old. I never knew I could wish the death of any man. He's taken everything from me, my loved one. Now he's come between you and me.
If I could take you far away. But I know it's impossible. What's to become of us, Sheila?
Don't think about it. I know only that you're here now near me.
Is there no consolation for you in your life as queen?
No, it's okay. The only reality is you and me, Rhys. Her arms would hold me close to you. These moments. I cannot believe there will be no more of them.
Neither can I.
Before I came to you, I hesitated. I made up all sorts of silly excuses about why I was coming. I knew it would be difficult. I know what you were trying to tell me, darling. If we're caught in the stuff. But my only happiness is with you.
Drawn when I reach out to you. What are you trying to do? Drive me to madness? Is that what you want? Tell me, is that it? I need you so, Sheila. Your arms, your perfume, your body. These hands. I want to feel them trembling, pulsing as they press against me. Oh, Sheila. You know, I've prayed so long that your heart would change toward me.
Your soldiers brought me to you, Nemeret, not my heart. I was a slave, remember? I had no choice. I was desperate.
but I'm no longer a slave. So I'll no longer submit to you. Now go away and leave me.
I shall take a whip to you until the warm blood flows from that body as cold as marble. You have blood, haven't you?
No, I have, Nemric. When you touch me, it runs cold.
Come with me. Come on, you're coming with me. You belong to me and you've got to stay with me. No woman can treat me like this, not even the most beautiful woman in the world. Catherine! Catherine! Leave your husband and wife and come out here and see how I take fire! The Assyrians are all my slaves, and you too are my slave. On your knees! Go, summon everyone! I want everyone to see! Don't! I alone am your master. Your life is in my hands. Humble yourself. Break me for mercy, or I swear I'll kill you right here at my feet. I want to see them written with your blood! With your blood! Slave.
This is one of his feet.
Perhaps. It could be our opportunity.
Madden. May the gods curse you for all eternity!
You're forgetting that the gods never curse other gods.
And I'm a god! I'm a god!
Stop her! Seize her! Why don't you stop her?
Lemuel!
Mother! Mother!
We must act quickly.
Don't lose your head. Get rid of this.
What has happened to him? He's very ill. Go call his physician. Hurry!
Move, quickly. Go. He was like a madman. This is the worst attack I've seen him have. He fainted and I brought him in here at once. It was all caused by a fight he had with Sheila.
Sheila? The Pharaoh is ill. You must go to him. You must go to him at once. No. He isn't like the ones before. See how rigid he is. Bring him back to his senses. I order you.
There is something I don't understand.
My mouth tastes bitter. I'm freezing.
Your mouth? Is it possible he was poisoned?
Poisoned?
Racy, help me, Racy. I feel cold all over.
Oh, save his life, Racy, I implore you.
Drink some of this. It's a powerful antidote.
She did it. But I'll have my revenge on her.
What's he saying, Nimrod? Nimrod, can you hear me? Look at me, Nimrod.
Listen to me. She's killed in a pay fight.
Don't move now. The blood must flow steadily in your veins.
Mother, you made me take a serpent to my bed.
Nimrod, you must try to keep calm.
Bring that woman here to me.
I want her to follow me to the tomb, but not to be happy in eternity. I want her to be buried with me alive. That way I can watch her perish and suffer and go on suffering through the centuries. Because her body will be destroyed and her soul will wander. Mother, she's the one who killed me.
She! What was the poison you used? Tell Razy at once exactly what it was while there is still time to save him. What do you say? It's not true. Those are only words of hatred he's speaking. Please, Nemeris, tell them you're only seeking revenge.
May the gods curse you and damn you for all eternity.
Ha ha ha!
How could you? Haven't we done more than enough for you? Did you think I brought him into the world only so you could come from Assyria and take him from me?
I swear
I never... Oh, if he had not already decided what your fate should be, I would have killed you in a different manner. Ripping each bit of flesh from your body, burning off both your hands, and tearing out your eyes. Look at him! Look at him! Because you will see only him before you when you are locked forever in the tomb with him to die.
I didn't do it. You know I'm innocent. He took the poison himself.
Away with her.
He was mad. He was mad. Why don't you believe me?
I would never have made the attempt. It's foolish to believe that she, the Queen Mother herself, would be willing to help you. It's absurd. You know what they call her? The old tigress. She bites and scratches.
But if there's the slightest doubt that it was Sheila who really did it, we must try to arouse the Queen's suspicions. Persuade her to investigate.
I agree. I think I've already started something. I've been buzzing like a fly, whispering in everyone's ear that Sheila is innocent. She's bound to be innocent. She had no reason. While there are some other people who...
I've heard these rumors. And they say that they're being circulated by someone in love with her.
Strictly between us. I don't think they're wrong.
If you so much as breathe the word.
Oh, as a fly, I'm the very soul of discretion.
Now she loathes her more than ever. She wants her removed at any cost. So does Hefren, because it serves its purpose to find a culprit. When I said it was poison, I should have cut out my tongue. Now I can't pretend to them it was something else.
That would help a lot.
You know, I have an idea, but it's terrifying. Besides, I'd have to get in to speak to her.
Some water.
Don't go away. Please don't.
Here.
Lizzie, take me out of here. It's already like a tomb.
Sheila, you must save your strength if we're to save you. Give me the ointment.
Why, cure me if you can't get me out. It's better to let me die.
You can put your trust in me. You must trust me.
They tried to make me confess. Did you know that?
I know.
I don't believe it, Lizzie. It's so terrible. I know Nemrut took the poison himself. I'd refused him that evening. It's his twisted way of revenging himself.
And it's all my fault that this has happened.
No. It would have happened eventually. At least I had a moment of happiness.
Listen, Sheila. For that brief moment of happiness, I have to ask you. I have to ask you to confess.
They sent you, didn't they?
No. No, Sheila, listen to me. Give me a chance to explain. It's the only way.
Don't touch me.
Look into my eyes, Sheila. Do you think I'm trying to trick you?
Where is he? I see I can't go on hoping. I can't go on living in the darkness. Help me, help me to a quick death without warning.
No, never. Stand guard outside. Listen to me, Sheila. I am risking my life, and also your life. Yes, your life as well. For the sake of our happiness, are you ready to risk yours too?
Must I confess to satisfy Kefren?
If you confess, it will set his mind at rest. He'll think that you're resigned to your fate, and he'll have faith in me.
What do you intend to do?
Here is a phial which contains both of our destinies. When you drink this, you will fall into a coma resembling death. Afterwards, I will declare that you have poisoned yourself. The rest will then be easy to manage. A dead woman is not guarded like a live one. Do you follow me?
They'll take me to the house of death.
But I'll be there, too.
But they'll lock me in the tomb.
They will never lock you into the tomb. By then, we'll be far away. Believe me, Sheila, I've planned it all. I've made arrangements with someone who will help us. It cannot fail.
When?
The next time I come back to you here. It cannot be before then. Otherwise, it would arouse their suspicions. Perhaps I won't be alone, but I shall give you a signal that I'm ready.
The royal scribe has taken her confession. I hope that certain rumors will cease. In my ears, they were no more than whining mosquitoes. Be that as it may, I shall cut out the tongue of anyone who dares mention her name again. I've published an edict banning this name. Have you prepared all the details for the funeral?
All is ready. The barge of the golden sarcophagus. But what of her?
She will be tied to the litter which bears the sarcophagus like a prisoner, a slave. And everyone will see her and throw rocks and mud at the murderess of our sovereign.
Inuni. The tomb? I completed my masterpiece yesterday. The guards are under strict surveillance, isolated from everyone.
Are you sure this will be your masterpiece?
There's no doubt of it. Therefore, I've asked that my name be inscribed on the great doors.
Very well. I've begun collecting the objects that must be buried in the tomb with him.
So I see.
Nearly everything is here now.
Yes, all but the most important thing. His throne.
It will be there. We are delighted to see you again in such good health.
I would never have come out of my chamber of sorrows if it weren't that I have a duty I must accomplish. In this casket, I have collected all the amulets and jewels that I desire to have placed beside Nemorak. I entrust them to you.
Take them, Raisi. To the house of death.
There is an inventory of it all.
Check every item with the scribe. You shall be personally responsible.
Great Queen. While you are here, and there is also Kephren, we, the sacred priests of Amun, would like to speak to you of a question we consider of extreme importance.
Go now. Each of you has his orders.
Our poor nation is undergoing a regrettable period of disorder now. We would be willing, therefore, to approve the elevation of Kephren to the throne. It is the moment for a man of force, and he is the man required. However, let's face the truth. Some of the populace might call him a pharaoh pretender. As you know, his origins
are... Just because I began at the bottom of the ladder. There's no reason.
Certainly. It's only another way of saying you're a man of ambition, intelligence, and decision. All the qualities of a true king. But no one must be permitted to impugn your authority. We ourselves, to be able to put the crown on you...
What else do you require?
Only one thing. Keiji.
I follow you. I shall have to legitimatize his claim to power.
You, by marrying him, would raise him to the throne. And together, the two of you will found a new dynasty.
Yes. For this, yes. But only for that reason. Another son of mine to inherit the throne. And on whom fortune will look with favor and intelligence.
You must arrange a formal repudiate Taya. If you wish, I shall speak to her myself.
Who is it?
Raisi, the physician.
Only you, physician. Karsutek, Raisi is here.
Karsutek, the court physician is here.
Sutek, the court physician is here.
Wait for me.
Very well.
Don't waste those bandages, you idiots. Don't bother too much about that one. They're not paying anything for the job. Ah, this is a filthy profession considering what they pay us.
These are the royal jewels for the pharaoh.
Very well. Come.
Here's the full inventory. Remember, it must bear your seal.
And for that other business?
Here is the first installment, as we agreed.
The jewels of the Pharaoh are worth 100 times as much.
Yes, but if you touch them, you risk your neck. With me, you risk nothing.
That's what you say.
You can easily obtain the body of a young woman. No one will be aware of the substitution.
I know what I have to do. Listen, tomorrow night at sundown, Kefren and the priest will attend the closing of the sarcophagi. And the day after that, at the first light of dawn, they will begin the funeral. We have the whole of one night to act in. Does your slave know what he's to do?
Yes, he'll be waiting with a boat at the river entrance.
May the gods assist us all. Don't forget to bring the rest you owe me tomorrow evening.
Don't worry.
Call your commander! Assemble all the guards. They will escort the prisoner.
Prepare yourself. You must go to the temple for purification. A royal tomb awaits you.
I was promised impunity if I confessed.
You were promised that? And by whom?
The physician.
Can it be that in your nation the physicians are empowered to grant pardons to criminals?
Then you lied to me.
You have acknowledged your guilt to me. Go courageously to face your punishment. Get ready now.
I'm ready.
Guard! Stop! Crazy!
Your fine physician couldn't save Nemrut, nor will he save me. It is the same poison.
Go for my medicine. She must not die yet. The populace is waiting to see her in chains, tied to the sarcophagus of Nemrut. The people have the right to be witnesses to her punishment.
There's nothing more I can do for her. It's the poison she used to kill Nemrut. There's no remedy.
Alas, let there be weeping. Our master has departed for the land where he will live eternal life. Thou who once walked the earth, behold thyself wrapped about with linen. Here I am.
The boat's outside. There isn't a moment to lose.
Did you bring what you owe me? Well, you can get out of here now.
Zultek!
I told you to get out of here. I've already done too much. I've already risked too much for the little you've given me. Did you think I'd risk my neck and eternal damnation?
I'll break your neck myself if you don't help me.
You and who else? The Assyrians, perhaps?
What do you mean, the Assyrians?
Maybe you believe I'm stupid. Did you think I didn't understand there was a plot afoot? Oh, Set, great god of the underworld, give me strength. You wanted to rescue the princess and put her back on the throne. And how much have you paid out for this? How much? Tell me. You expect me to settle for less than 10 times what you've already given me?
All right. You get what you want.
That won't do. No, I want it now. I don't believe in promise.
Do you think everyone's a swindler like you? Come on now, open the door.
What if she's already dead? Keep calm, or I warn you, it'll be the worst for you if you really meant it when you told me that you loved her. I can let you have one last look at her. Be grateful for that. The gods will bless me for this act of charity. If I had killed her, there would be no more argument now. But I was afraid of being cursed by the dead Pharaoh. He wanted her to be alive in the tomb with him. As you see, the woman is still alive. Stand back. Another move and I'll shout until this room is filled with guards. I'm warning you.
You wouldn't dare. The guards would ask you too many questions.
I'm tired of slitting the bellies of only dead bodies. Get out of here.
All right, I can't beat you. You win.
Oh.
Master. Master, you must escape.
Guard!
Come. Get up. That's it. Come on.
This way.
Reopen your wound. Come back and lie down.
Leave me alone, I said. Don't say a word.
Here I am.
Get some men together. A lot of men. We must take clubs and stones. We must go at once.
You must have a fever.
What? You afraid? Is there no one who will help us? Where are all my friends here? The people who swore they would give their lives for me. Who will come with me? If there's no one, I'll go alone.
Hello. Anusi, help. Just a minute.
Nabor. There's one person who can help us.
Yes.
He must help us. The architect. He knew me, but he won't want to.
Yes, Master.
We'll search for him and bring him to me here at once. He can help us.
Yes, Master.
Come. calm yourself now. Inuni, if he refuses, we should... The bandits, the ones who arrive for the tombs, the valley's full of them, they say, will break into the tomb. Tell her we must save her.
To my dignity. Here I am, superintendent of the necropolis, man denied access to the tomb. And they're going to kill my most trusted workman.
Don't be upset. You know we'll soon have a new pharaoh.
Oh, certainly. With Kefren, we have an understanding. And Inuni will pay for this insult.
Bring along those stones. Hurry.
Are you ready now?
It's ready to be sealed. Do the guards know what they're to do when the workers are finished?
They know. They're ready to do as you're commanded.
Good. You are as good a doctor as you are a liar, Raisi. It's obvious, isn't it? Your filthy bandits attacked me and brought me here to their leader. To you, Raisi. Now I understand your long voyages.
Master, let me slap his face for you.
Inuni, I tell you once more and for the last time. I swear that Sheila is alive in that tomb and that she's innocent. You know the real assassin is Kefren.
I have constructed a tomb. It matters very little whether its occupant was killed by one man or another.
But the woman is alive. You have to save her.
I have constructed a tomb that cannot and must not be violated. It is a vow I've made to myself. A vow more binding than any made to all the gods and pharaohs in whom I do not believe.
But as I've been telling you over and over again, nothing will be touched, nothing will be changed a bit. We'll vanish forever, the two of us. And let everyone believe we're dead. That's what I want. And let them believe the same of me.
Raise your hair-raising tales of love and romance should be set to music and sung to kings and concubines. You underestimate my intelligence. Why, I already have taken all precautions against robbers like you. But that tomb bears my name. And all the world will still remember Inuni long after you have become a common grain of desert sand.
Master, this man is insane. You're only wasting your time with him.
There's nothing left but to call Amazi, believe me, and the other bandits. I've informed him. All I have to do now is send for him.
Very well, hurry. You've brought this on yourself. Chief of the bandits, am I? I'll be the chief if I have to. Give me thieves instead of your pride. They'll certainly be more humane. Architect, I wouldn't like to be in your place before long.
Is it true you don't want any of the plunder?
I only want you to help me get the woman out. I'll even give you the architect who knows how to open the tomb.
I'm wondering if the sun hasn't addled your brain. A tomb just closed. And besides, we had specific orders to stay out of that one for a while, and you know it.
Who gave you the orders? Aren't you their leader?
No one. No one is giving us orders, or no one will give us orders again. That's the advantage of this robbery. There's enough inside there to make us rich for the rest of our lives without protection from anyone.
Do you want to move without warning him? If he ordered us to suspend all our raids, it's because there must be some danger.
Some danger for him? What does that matter? The lion's share was his, and he always left us the risk.
Maris is right. If we don't take advantage of this opportunity...
You always make us listen to Maris. And you know women bring bad luck.
You know, my father was the most successful robber of tombs that ever lived. I was no more than a baby when he first took me on his expedition. My father was a man who never hesitated.
I still say the job is an easy one, precisely because it seems so difficult. A tomb just closed? It's perfect. No one would expect it. The guards are always on patrol around the ancient tombs.
And besides, what's better than helping two lovebirds? Who knows? Why, someday we might be known to all the historians.
Well, can't you reach a decision? Will you help me or not? In a few hours, she'll wake up again.
We'll see you get her back safe and sound. Your princess will be rescued. Am I right?
We might as well attempt it for what we stand to make out of it.
I wouldn't do it ordinarily. However, when do we go to work? We'll begin right after dark this evening. This heat is suffocating, if you ask me. I'm going to get some rest before...
Hey, this is no time to be resting. You'd better go get the tools and ropes ready and see that everything is in order. As for the architect, we'd better let him have a taste of this whip just to make him understand who we are and that he'll do well to obey us.
I'm amazed that you could dream of opening your arms to the woman whose son you murdered.
Tyre, you're forgetting that Nemerach was murdered by Sheila. This is the real truth, and the only real truth.
No. You are forgetting that our secret binds us more strongly than any wedding vow.
But Tyre, what are you saying? We are bound together but by a slender thread. If you break it, I will not fall alone.
Perhaps that would not be of the least importance to me. Rather than be repudiated as if I were a slave, my thoughts were yours. My only dream was to be queen at your side.
But, Tyre, won't you believe me? It's not I, but the priests who do this. They would refuse to crown me, and they told me as much.
Well, stand up to them, then.
The priests are too powerful at the moment to...
Will things be any different for you when you marry that creature?
The army is loyal to the queen.
All right. Then I've killed a man for nothing.
If someone else became pharaoh, believe me, it would be worse for you.
I have killed a man. And at night, sometimes I'm afraid. If I were queen, I wouldn't be afraid.
Oh, don't talk nonsense, Tyre. And believe that I'll make you the happiest of all women. You'll be first among my concubines. And everyone will respect you as if you were truly a queen. Because everyone will see that you are the real ruler of my heart. Think about it. Isn't it better this way? You shall have all your heart desires.
I was sure of it, Kevin. I could have believed you before. Oh, leave me alone.
May the gods be with you. I'll be waiting for you at the cave, but be careful, I beg you.
Shall we go?
Yes, let's go.
Haven't you learned your lesson yet? No more tricks, is that clear? a single guard. What did I tell you? Did you hear what I told you? Murdering lunatic. I'll kill you right here. I'll flay you alive with this whip, and then I'll leave you inside here to die. Enough, Amati. If you don't show us the right way, I'll put your eyes out. I mean what I'm saying.
Wait. Is it here?
As long as you show us the right way. Speak up!
It's useless to resist you any longer. This way. Thank you.
which stone should be removed.
Try this one.
Don't make us waste our time. Which is it? Come on.
Hold this.
Step on my shoulder. Be careful.
Break through that wall, and you'll be as rich as a pharaoh.
Help me! Help me!
Tina!
Get out of here! I'm
going to
save you!
Please, get me out of here!
Yes! Hold on a little longer! Daniel, no! Did you hear that? She's alive! She's alive! Come on! Tina! You're safe! Hurry up, come on!
Don't be impatient. You're only ruining your hands. Leave it to the others whose job it is. We will save her.
You blundering idiot. Why didn't you warn me of this sooner? I tried to come to you at once, but I was prevented. They shall have the punishment they deserve. Amazi, Maris, and all the others. After all these years, I've helped them and protected them. And this is their gratitude to me. But the story about Sheila and Raisi, do you think is the truth?
Raisi's words were convincing.
Call the mounted guards at once. If Sheila is really alive, this is much more than a simple grave robbery. It's something that might upset the whole of Egypt. But you haven't let a word of this slip out to anybody, have you, or have you?
You know me.
Come with me. We've no time to lose. Come on.
Thank you, Inouye.
Now go.
Hey, you are going to let those two get away, are you? They're the kind of talk if they get captured.
Let me pass you.
Do you think it'll be so easy to find your way out of here? By this time, Razy will have put out the lamps. You came in here with me, and only with me can you leave.
Let me pass, I tell you.
Put down that knife. I want the satisfaction of choosing my own way of dying. And there are still some things I want to do.
Get out of my way.
Go if you want to. But remember Ubnet.
Let's go. Leave that stuff alone.
But there's so much treasure here.
But the most precious jewels are on the mummy. Bring your tools and let's try to open the sarcophagus.
Hold!
Those must be their mounts. You're right.
Forward, men at the gallop.
Together, with all your strength.
Should
be happening. It is the death I have chosen for myself as well as for all of you.
Run for your lives! Hurry!
Personally searched the entire valley, even into the desert as far as the Red Rocks. The only thing we could find was the trail left by their horses' hooves leading toward Sinai. There was nothing more I could do. I couldn't give free rein to the men since I no longer trusted them altogether. You understand me, don't you? But you give the impression that you're not listening.
I hear you, unfortunately.
Those miserable curs. And that physician.
No one knows about this?
Only we two.
And that spy of yours?
His power of speech has left him.
I believe in reading the stars. The astrologer has told me they're favorable to me right now.
Obviously, you shall be pharaoh.
And a physician may wreck it all.
I wouldn't say so. It's even probable that Raisi and Sheila are buried along with the others. After all, these amulets are not uncommon, you know.
But how can I be sure of it? By making 200 slaves excavate the tomb? It's more than one day's work, and not a job that can be done with any secrecy. No, Mano, there's that trail of horses' hoofs to Sinai. That should lead us to the truth. The trail's the answer. I shall follow it with some men I can rely on.
I shall be at your side.
However, perhaps I shouldn't put my complete trust in you, Mano.
Why should you be in doubt? I've proven my fidelity.
And I know certain things that you don't know. For example, why it was the tomb caved in. You made me think that Inuni was an accomplice of the thieves. Why did you want to lie to me that way?
But, Kevin, you don't understand. No, Kevin, let me explain it to you. No, Kevin, wait!
Where are you going?
Our traitor! Who sent you here? I am the Pharaoh!
Merciful an end for him. He was struck down at the height of his dreams of ambition, satisfied with all that he had unlawfully achieved. For the murderer of my son, I would have chosen a more lingering death.
Have all his followers arrested at once.